I walked into Sci Falls on August 25th, and I looked around and saw a lot of adults. It was different, but I was excited to have moved on and be a step closer to finishing school. I used to be very ignorant to the fact that school was important, so I didn't really pay attention in class at all. I tried pretty hard to maintain a reputation that wasn't me at all, and I still cared what everyone thought of me. If someone didn't like me, I took it to heart, and every little mistake I made seemed to be the end of the world. But I still thought I was invincible. Nobody could change my mind about anything. I'll admit, I was a stubborn little brat. I thought I could sleep in every class and still pass. I got a huge slap in the face that summer because I had to waste a whole month of my summer in summer school. Lesson learned.
Cast the white flag up the pole where only you can see. Climb the stairs into the dark. Check my pulse and watch me breathe. Disregard your battered arms. In a minute they'll find.
Going into sophomore year, I convinced myself to join wrestling again after quitting my freshman year. Of course, I was put down a lot because of it, but that was just background noise. I wanted to actually be someone and be involved in something. That was my biggest motivator. I also was extremely out of shape after a long summer of a lot of late night Taco Bell rounds with my friends. My ignorant self thought it would never catch up to me. Well, it did. I went into wrestling at 165 pounds, but after a lot of physical and mental training, I ended up losing 30 pounds by the end of that season. I was down to 138 at one point, and I was pretty proud of myself. Wrestling became a big part of me that year. It taught me a lot, and I ended up loving it more than expected. It was all I could think about or even dream about. Going into junior year and realizing that I was 3/4 of the way done with high school was the craziest feeling. But what was I going to do with my life after high school? What was going to matter after high school? For a long time, it was a childish dream of mine to become a police officer. I figured it was time to start working on making that dream a reality. I finally had a dream, I finally had a goal that motivated me more than anything. Junior year in wrestling, I became closer than ever to my teammates. They were all basically family to me. We definitely shared a lot of laughs and memories that I will never forget. And I found some of my closest friends in wrestling, and for that, I'm forever thankful. First things first, rest in peace, sucker fair. For real, you the only father that I ever knew. I get my shit pregnant, I'ma be a better you. Prophecies that I made way back in the veil. For fear, listen, even back when we was broke, my team ill. Martin Luther King would have been on Dreamville, talk to her. One time for my LA sisters, one time for my LA. Lame chicken can't tell the difference. One time for a girl who knows. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. 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 No role models and I'm here right now. No role models to speak of. Searching through my memory, I couldn't find one. Last night I was getting my feet rubbed by the baddest shit. Not Trina, but I swear to God, it's good to make you call your girl up and tell her, hey, what's good? Sorry, I'm never coming home, I'ma stay for good. They hang the phone up. Going into senior year and being able to say that this is my last first day of school was the best feeling. It was scary and exciting at the same time. I was happy that I knew what I was going to be doing after high school. And have everything planned out for the next 4 or 5 years. Still wanting to be the most bad A female police officer in town, My major is going to be in criminal justice. I had a dream and ambition and no one was going to stop me. Also, I went and applied at animal hospitals and I wanted to work out. I landed a volunteer job at Cypress Falls Animal Hospital that soon turned into a part-time job. I was happy to be working with animals every day at work. I still to this day really love my job. I went into senior year thinking that it was going to be the longest, most exhausting year, but to my surprise, it went by in the blink of an eye. Virtually painless, sorta. I learned that procrastinating isn't always the best option, but sometimes it just happens. And if you're going to procrastinate, learn to put the pro in procrastinate. Here we are, a couple weeks away from graduation, and those painful nights of thinking that school will never be over seem pointless now. I'm gonna need my shirt back. Yeah, you know how I go. One time for my LA sisters. One time for my LA hoes. Lame niggas can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. 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 There's an old saying in Tennessee. I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once. Shame on you. It fooled me, we can't get fooled again. Fool me one time, shame on you. Fool me twice, can't put the blame on you. Fool me three times, open the peace sign, load the chopper, let it rain on you. Fool me one time, shame on you. Fool me twice, can't put the blame on you. Fool me three times, put the peace sign, load the chopper, let it rain on you. My only regret was too young for Lisa Bonet. My only regret was too young for me alone. Now all I'm left with is hustle from reality shows and the script. They probably couldn't read alone. My only regret was too young for Sade Adu. My only regret could never take Aaliyah home. Now all I'm left with is hustle with Greystone. With the stale face, cause they know it's they song. She shallow with the beauty, she shallow. She shallow with the she shallow. She shallow. She shallow with the she shallow. She shallow. She shallow. She shallow with the she shallow. She shallow. Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved. 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 Don't save her. She don't wanna be saved.